Having said that, let's understand the topic too. That is, what are the various types of promotional strategies? They generally fall into two categories. That is, the push strategies or the pull strategies. First one, that is the push strategy. As the name indicates, this is when the product is taken to the customer by the company. This is mostly used when the product is an impulse purchase or if the company has an established relationship with the customer base. Companies may sell directly from their showrooms or at the trade shows, etc. Essentially, there is less need to create an advertising buzz and more to make the product readily available at the retail outlets and showrooms. Push marketing may focus primarily on the short-term sales. On the contrary, the second strategy is the pull strategy. In the opposite approach, there is an attempt to pull the customers towards the brand or the particular product. Through mass media campaigns to sales promotions and personal references, a company attempts to create brand loyalty and attractiveness. Pull strategies may attempt to focus primarily on the long-term brand loyalty than high sales in the short run. A lot of media hype and mass campaign are required to create sufficient interest and encourage the customers to seek out the product on their own. Most companies will generally use a mix of both the push and the pull strategies at different points of time. The second thing to consider is how to manage promotion through the various stages of product life cycle. As already said in our previous sessions, a product, or every product for that matter, typically goes through a four-stage cycle, starting with the introduction stage, to the growth stage, to the maturity and the saturation stage, and finally a decline stage. Generally, an introduction stage is a stage which is characterized wherein the product is just newly introduced into the market, wherein the sales are just initially starting, hence profits have not really started taking place for the company, and there are no competitors for the product in the market. However, the growth stage is the one wherein sales are increasing at an accelerating rate and so are the profits. The competitors have also realized the potential of this particular stage and have already set it into the market. The third stage is the maturity stage, wherein sales are still increasing but at a declining rate as compared to the growth stage. And so are the profits increasing but at a decelerating level compared to the growth level. The competitors have already even taken over the market completely over here. Followed by the maturity stage, many of the products go through a saturation stage. Saturation stage is a stage wherein we do not have any more new purchasers or buyers for our product. That is, all the people or all the consumers interested in our products are already buying. Hence, we shall only have replacement sales or resales. No new sales or purchases should happen in this level. Finally, the decline level, wherein the product is about to be eliminated from the market and the competitors have also exited, seeing no more potential in the market. Sales are declining and so are the profits at this level. Understanding the various different stages, the promotion techniques adopted by the companies also changes in the different stages. Let's look into that. In the introduction stage, at this stage, major promotional campaigns and activities will be designed and executed. A comprehensive promotional mix will be designed with full input from the rest of the marketing mix. The aim here is to provide detailed information about the product, its features and benefits. Special offers and sales promotion may also be used to pull in the customers, while in some markets, push strategies may be used simultaneously employed. The second being the growth stage. Once the product is established and accepted, there will be a shift in the strategy from information to more emotional aspects. The aim is to increase brand awareness at this level, create strong brand equity, and foster long-term customer loyalty. Hence, at this stage, the companies need to aim at more of retaining the customers rather than getting the new customers for themselves. Having said that, let's move to the third stage, that is the maturity stage. By now, the markets have matured and there may be stiff competition and similar products available because even the competitors have realized the potential of this particular product in the market and they have entered the market similarly. Promotional activities hence will turn now to become more persuasive and there is an attempt to create product differentiation by highlighting specific benefits and features that fulfills the needs and are unique. At this stage, various product differentiation and innovation techniques are employed by the companies. And finally, the decline stage. At this point, the promotional activities may wind down to occasional reminders that the product still exists and in an attempt to forestall the product's eventual decline. Here, not much amount is spent or not much energy and effort is put in to the promotional activities because the product is dying a natural death at this level. Let's move to our third topic, that is communication. Before understanding what communication is, it is very important to understand why are we understanding communication in the promotional aspect. Well, as already said initially, the four major tools of promotions are advertising, sales promotion, public relations, and personal selling. Well, all the four tools employed by promotions directly and indirectly involve nothing but communication. Hence, it is very important to understand what does communication mean and what are the various elements involved in communication. Having said that, communication may be defined as a process concerning the exchange of facts or ideas between people holding different positions in an organization to achieve mutual harmony. The communication process is a very dynamic process in nature rather than a static phenomena. It is a process which must be considered as continuous and dynamic interaction, both affecting and being affected by various variables. Having said that, let's understand what are the major elements for a communication process. They primarily being the sender, the ideas, encoding, communication channel, receiver, decoding, and feedback. That is, it is a seven element or a seven stage process, which starts with the sender. So, who really is the sender? Sender is the person who intends to convey the message or initiates this entire communication process with the intention of passing the information and ideas to others, is known as a sender or a communicator. In our promotional techniques, generally it is the seller who is the sender who wants to convey the image or information about its product or wants to convey information about the particular brand. Hence, he is the initiator for a communication here, being the sender. The second part is the ideas, which is the subject matter of communication. It could be anything from opinions to attitude to feelings to views to orders or suggestions. Here, generally, it is nothing but the product information which goes from the sender to the receiver, or in a vice versa channel, it can even go in terms of feedback of the product or improvisations or market report from the consumers to the seller. Third being encoding. Since the subject matter of communication is theoretical and intangible, its further passing requires use of certain symbols such as words, actions, or pictures, or etc. Conversion of subject matter into these symbols is the process of encoding. This is the step which is taken care of by the sender. The next step being communication channel. The person who is interested in communicating has to choose the channel for sending the required information, idea, or message across. This information is transmitted to the receiver through certain channels, which may be either formal or informal. Formal channels are the ones which are clear-cut, designed, and authorized and designated by the organization. For example, the line structure or the soft structure. However, informal communication is the one which can happen at any random level across any divisions of the organization. They do not follow any fixed pattern. The next element is the receiver. Receiver is the person who is getting the information or the message, or for whom the message is meant for. It is the receiver who tries to understand the message in the best possible manner in achieving the desired objectives. In a promotional strategy, the receiver has to get the main message of the product or the brand across. That is, understand the key uses of the product or the special benefits or features that the product has to offer. Or understand how this particular brand is different from the competitor's brands and what is its competitive advantage. The next element being decoding. The person who receives the message or symbol from the communicator tries to convert the same in such a way so that he may be able to extract or attach some meaning so that to understand the message completely. This is called as decoding. Obviously, this is the element which is taken care of by the receiver. The next and the final element being feedback. This is the process of ensuring that the receiver has received the message and understood it exactly in the same sense and manner as the sender meant it. Without this element, that is the feedback element, the entire communication process goes for a toss. Because, as initially said, communication is not about just passing meaning and information, but more importantly about passing the understanding from the sender to the receiver. Having said that, let's understand the various forms of communication. It basically can be communicated into two different heads: verbal communication and non-verbal communication. Verbal communication is that part of the communication which is explicitly spoken or written. That is oral communication or written communication. Oral is the one which happens with the help of phone calls or direct talking, speeches, etc. Whereas written communication is done through letters, emails, faxes, etc. And the second component being the non-verbal communication. Non-verbal communication is the communication which accounts for almost 70% of the communication being taken place. This basically includes the body language, the silence, the smile, the posture, the gestures, the hand movement, etc. This is the non-spoken and the non-written part of the communication which plays a very important role in actually passing on the subtle information of the communication. Having said that, let's summarize the session. In the first topic, we spoke about the important considerations in the promotional decisions. Second topic, we spoke about the promotional strategies and how to manage promotion through the product lifecycle. And finally, in the third topic, we spoke about communication and the various elements of communication.